Let me just go down.
What's up, guys? Welcome to another video. So I'm pretty excited today because on today's video, I got a new guitar for myself. Don't worry, my giveaway is still going on. Once the channel reaches 1,500 subscribers, we will be doing a guitar giveaway between an LP style guitar or a Strat style guitar. So speaking of Strat style guitars, I realized I really only have like a super Strat style guitar, and then I have my Sterling Stingray, which is like Strat-ish, but not really like a Strat style guitar. So I brought in one of my guitars that I rarely use. I think I used it on one like production I've done and played twice when I was in my old band. So I decided, let me go to a local music store here in New Jersey and see if I can do like a trade-in or sell-up. So I ended up actually getting some money for the guitar and was able to trade it in for something else. So the trade-in was for the Bad Boy in this case. And I'm gonna show you guys now. If you follow me on Instagram, I'm gonna tag my Instagram profile here. Then you've seen it last night. So this is my new Cort G100 Strat style guitar. Let me bring that a little bit closer. I mean, I'm freaking in love with this thing. This is the walnut color. It's got like that nice brown burst. And you can see, you know, the wood grain. There you go, let me get in the light, right? You can see some of that wood grain. This thing's amazing. Today's topic is basically like, are name brands worth it these days? I've been getting some DMs from my followers how they feel bad because they can't afford like a Fender or a Gibson or an expensive Ibanez. And I'm gonna be real with you, none of my guitars are over $500. I think my most expensive one is the Sterling Stingray, right around $350. So with today's video, all I'm gonna do to this guitar is I'm gonna change the nines that came on this and put 10 strings on this, 10 to 52s, I believe. I'm gonna put 10 to 54s on this bad boy. And then we're gonna produce something quick, and I want you guys to let me know how you feel about it in the comments below. This thing is super lightweight. I'm gonna run through the specs coming up, but yeah, this thing has double humbuckers, and I played it in the store and played it a little bit at my friend's house yesterday. Love this thing. For being able to get money in my pocket and walk away with a new guitar, I'm a happy camper. So these are for everybody that believes you have to have a Fender or a Gibson. And if you have any of those friends that keep talking up to that, tell them to go fuck themselves, because like budget guitars are no longer what they were in early 2000s, late 90s. They are being made with quality specs. And if you're a beginner or even an intermediate player, again, and if you are not doing live shows or playing in front of big audiences, there's no need to have that brand name. Take it from some guy who's worked in marketing for the past decade. Brand names are just that, a name. You're paying for that name. Your skill is not gonna be any better with a Fender or a Gibson Les Paul, Gibson SG. None of that matters. It's all about the player. Of course, materials are better, sure. But if you can get your hand on a quality sub-series guitar, I promise you, your pockets will thank you, and your playing isn't gonna be any better just because you got a better guitar. So stick around, guys. I'm gonna change the strings on this, maybe polish up the fretboard, and we're gonna produce something on this. All right, guys, so here's the tone we've pulled. I've used Stevie T's ML Sound Labs for all the amp sims on this track. So here we go. We'll be right back. Alright guys, so I hope you enjoyed the video of the Cort G100HH guitar. So I told you I'd give you guys a quick breakdown of the specs. So, it's a double cutaway guitar, Strat style guitar, with power sound pickups. Power sound pickups are produced by Ibanez for their more affordable line. So again, you just heard how these things sounded. I think they sound really good for the price. We've got a three-way selector switch to go between the two pickups and in between. We have one volume, one tone, pretty simple. We've got a 25.5 scale length fretboard. We have a maple body fretboard. And we have the body of the guitar is a wood called, I'm going to read it on the back of this camera, I'm not going to lie. The body of this guitar is called Marante. We have a 12-inch radius fretboard, 22 frets, 25.5 scale length fretboard, die cast tuners, and chrome hardware for the bridge. And then we have a bolt-on neck design, skunk tail back. And that's basically it. So if you guys like the sound of this, leave the video a thumbs up. Share this with someone you know who may be looking for an affordable guitar. And again, if you have anybody telling you you need to have brand name guitars, as I said earlier, tell them to f*** themselves. Alright guys, see you in the next one.